Morning. So, I recently bought The Swordsmanship of Renaissance Italy, a great book. You can expect a review on this channel soon. And one thing in particular struck me, and that was a discussion of different grips of a one-handed sword. And they cite Gisiero, which is a Renaissance Italy fencing master, and he presents these four different grips with their individual pros and cons. So the first is the usual thumb grip. Especially if you study the Lichtenauer tradition, you should be quite familiar with it. But for the one-handed sword, it can be quite tricky actually. So he writes that this grip helps you to make good and straight strikes, but it does not allow to make good thrusts, and the hand does not exercise all of its force since it's half open. So what he means is that if you put your thumb on the grip, that you have like a little space here, which naturally will lead to a less strong grip with the rest of your fingers. From experience and looking at other sources, you can for sure say that they thrust and strike. So this might take some practice, but I think you can get used to it quite well. And this is a grip I would especially recommend if you have no finger rings, since it's pretty safe that way to get your arm and your sword into one line. So that's actually pretty good for thrusts in my opinion. Okay. The next grip he is presenting is a grip with the palm towards the ground. I got to know this grip especially due to Marte Mayhem's lecture on Thibaut. And it's nothing else than you're putting your finger through the finger ring and you have basically your sword in a seconda. So I don't know if you can see it here, I probably play some other footage here as well. So this leads that the palm of your hand will support the pommel quite well and the sword in your hand gets really, really light. You can also thumb the grip here. That's no problem at all. You can also don't do it. It doesn't really matter. It's a grip you can exercise with the typical sword, with the finger rings and everything. But of course, this would be also possible for the usual arming sword. No problem at all. What he mentions is, as a pro, that the sword is really light. So that's quite nice. And that the system with this grip is really thrust-centered. So he describes it as a grip where there are a lot of changes of lines. So like little cavationis, which he describes then again imperfect, but well, that's maybe just his taste. And you can you need to change your grip to throw proper cuts. So he describes in this grip there are no proper cuts you can make, but of course if you have again a look at the lecture on Thibaut, there's an easy grip change into a usual grip where you can then again cut and thrust. Okay, so really nice if you are focusing on these little cavationes and trying to thrust into your opponent. Okay, so the third grip we would nowadays refer to as a hammer grip, and it should feel quite natural actually. So it's just gripping your sword, thumb on the side. You can put it again on the blade if you'd like to, but it's a pretty straightforward grip. It throws great strikes, you have nice control, nice edge alignment he describes as well, but the thing is the angle between the sword and the forearm is actually pretty acute. So if you want to thrust or strike, you lose some range because you are not taking the direct way to your opponent, but you're taking a little detour. Okay, you can of course circumvent this, and if you go into more of like handshake grip, so you actually loosen your grip like a little bit, and then this angle gets wider and wider. Okay, so again, I would say this grip has specific pros in some circumstances, especially if you're really close or you need to throw strong strikes and need nice edge alignment, then this can be of course quite useful. Okay, and the last, and he describes it as the perfect grip, would be with the index finger over the cross. So the more or less typical Italian Renaissance swordsmanship grip is what is surprised, the perfect one for him, where you can strike nice strikes with the edge, you can thrust, we have a wide angle between our forearm and our blade, so this should go really nice. I would recommend you to train all of these grips, play around with them, get to know their different situations where they're good at, and just have some fun. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Moin. Ah ne, ich wollte ja eigentlich auf Englisch reden, ne?
Moin.
Moin.
Morning. Nice day for fishing.
Enid. What?
Morgen ist es soweit.